Welcome to Rise with Chuck. Let's take a look in the vault, see what we've got for this week's video. Mini tractor trailer. We'll take a look at mini tractor trailer.
People have asked me, Chuck, when are you going to put a tractor trailer on your program? Well, I've never found one that was really interesting enough until now. I'd like to introduce you to Dave Kelm and his wife Janet. Dave, what have we got here?
Well, it's just as you can see, it's just a big toy, really. It's something I've always wanted to build over the years. I've driven semis all my life, off and on. I owned one for a while. It's just something I wanted to do to try to build a miniature one.
This is the smallest tractor trailer I've ever seen.
Yeah, it's approximately half scale. It's 23 feet long, about 5.5 feet tall, 4.5 feet wide, weighs about 2.5 ton.
Janet, what were you thinking when he said, I want to build a miniature tractor trailer?
He's been talking, doing it for years, and finally I said, if you're going to do it, you better get started. He just one day started and...
I thought I'd do it before I got too old to get to know to be able to do it. So.
You know how to put this thing together. What makes it move?
Well, it's like I said, I just started with the rear ends and started adding pieces. I didn't have any plans that I followed. There's a 4-cylinder Isuzu diesel engine in it out of a Chevy Chevette. The transmission is Chevette. The rear ends or wing wheels are all Chevy Chevette. There's parts in it from combines and Jeeps and pickup trucks and tractors and lawnmowers, and it's just I just love to build with my hands.
Is this what people do in the country in the winter, in the long dark winter evenings?
Yeah, there's 2.5 years of all my spare time sitting here. And
once in a while I have to call and remind him it was supper time.
She said she'd call on the phone and say, are you coming in for supper? And I'd look at my watch and, oh, I'm only half an hour late. Yeah, I guess I'm coming in. And I'd go back out after supper and stay out there till midnight some nights. It's just something I always love to do, building things.
But you made this to carry two people, right?
Right. Pretty tight for two people, but you can get two people in it.
But he takes it in parades and shows it to let other people enjoy it in parades and to car shows and... So other people get
Will you take our viewers for a ride in this truck?
We'll try, yeah, if we can get them all in there.
Two.
Two, okay, just two.
Dave and Jenna, really nice talking to you. I can't wait to see what this ride is like.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let's go for a ride in a truck. TV on your license plate, does that stand for a trailer vehicle?
No, that's an actual, the T stands for tractor and the V is the size of the plate. That's an actual semi-tractor plate that when I owned my tractor, I paid $1,800 for a little piece of tin. I thought I'd better use it for something over the years.
$1,800?
Yep, that's right. That's not the biggest one. Big semis on the over the road, they pay up over $2,000 for their plates.
I can see the beauty of this. I can see the interest that, I can see how neat it would be in a parade. But why did you do this?
Well, I don't know if there's really one particular reason why I started. Like I said before, it's something I've always wanted to do. And other people ask me that, and I tell them, you know, why do people climb Mount Everest? And just because it's there, it's something to do, it's a challenge. And that's kind of what it was for me. It was a challenge to do something like this, and I wanted to build something to drive in parades, and it turned out better, actually, than what I expected it to. And one thing leads to another, so here I am, I guess.
Is this project finished?
I have wheels and tires at home for possibly another trailer someday, but I have not started working on it yet, no.
Been talked about doing a tanker for it.
About building a tanker for it and put a beer tapper on the back of it and drive through parades that way. But.
Well, we'll keep our eyes open for that when it comes out, so I look forward to seeing that.